I'm Michael Krigsman. I'm here in New York City at IPsoft's Digital Workforce Summit. And I'm speaking with Tom DeCarlo, who is the head of client services for the Americas at the huge bank, UBS. Hey, Tom, how are you doing?
How are you?
Good. So tell us what you do at UBS.
So I think you outlined it. I'm the head of service, client services in the Americas. At UBS, so my primary responsibility is to lead the teams that support our financial advisors, their sales assistants, and of course, the account holders themselves.
What are the key issues you're looking at regarding the contact centers today?
So always some challenges, right? Always, when you sit within a function of operations, you're always looking to continuously improve, right? Improve upon your quality, your efficiency, and the way in which you're doing business overall. Client experience is always at the top of that list. And with technology, right, we're looking to evolve and become more efficient in doing all of those.
So Tom, how do you manage to improve the client experience and at the same time reduce your costs?
So it's a couple fold, right? So, you have the people, right? The workforce in itself is the primary driver of that, continuously training. And having a quality team that can focus in on specific types of training is a huge effort in itself, and we've self-funded a team to do that this year. Secondly is policy, process, and procedure. So we want to be as efficient as possible with our processes so that we have very little exceptions there. And thirdly is technology. So once you have well-trained people and clean procedures and policies, then you can begin to layer technology on top of it and show a good investment in ROI.
What are you doing with technology?
We're doing a lot of really cool things, right? We're looking at multi-channel communication, being able to interact via chat, SMS text, stuff like that, email. We're looking to improve, with our client experience and leverage some artificial intelligence, right, to assist us not only in supporting our field support teams, the FAs and the CSAs, but eventually having the artificial intelligence interact with our clients to support them.
When you talk about AI, can you drill down into what that actually means and what are you doing with it?
Great. So artificial intelligence to me, there's many different ways in which you can describe and define artificial intelligence. But when I think about AI, I think about the closest thing to a human being that I can have interacting with my clients at the highest level of quality. So somebody that they're not sure is human or not, as they're interacting, let it be via chat or voice, answering questions for them, probing them, disambiguating where needed, and having that high level of confidence to satisfy that client inquiry with the right answer the first time.
And that's the nature of your current project with IPsoft and Amelia.
That's correct, yes. Yeah. So we actually have completed phase one of a proof of concept pilot with a pretty complex business case on the retirement deceased distribution side of the business, where we have Amelia interacting with our CSAs, our sales assistants, in determining what documentation is necessary in order to have a distribution leave the retirement account once the client account holder had been deceased. So there are many different situations, many different dependencies and documents that need to be signed in order to do so. We taught Amelia, we trained her with training documentation, workflows, policy and processes, approvals as well, on the best way to do so. And she's interacting directly in this controlled environment with our CSAs at a high quality.
And you deliberately chose a process that's a particularly complex one.
Yes. So I wanted to prove not only that Amelia could work within a contact center, but I wanted to prove that this artificial intelligence in itself could be a tool that we could use across the firm for many different functional interactions. We could have chose password reset, right? And just about any type of bot can change a password. Identify, authenticate, change the password, re-enter that password, and it's done. But when you have an inquiry type that is robust, that can go in many different directions and requires some thought process, this artificial intelligence does the right job.
What's the response from your both from your customer service reps internally, customer advisors, as well as your external customers?
Sure. So the agents, right, our team members, our biggest asset, very excited to see it, right? If you think about it, a large majority of the folks that, that come into the organization right out of school, millennials, right, they're really excited about the new technology. And the artificial intelligence is right there at the top of their list. From a client perspective, my internal clients that we've piloted this with love it, absolutely love it. And they had advice, you know, recommendations, and wanted to know how quickly we're going to get this to production.
So people feel very positive about the results.
Yes, results have been positive to date. IPsoft has assisted me in being able to share the POC across the rest of my organization with a short movie, a video, outlining exactly what we did, how we did it, showing the interaction in itself, better than going across the organization with a PowerPoint trying to state, you know, what we did.
What are the objectives that you hope to achieve with this?
So always looking to become more efficient, right, and improve the client experience through quality. And I think artificial intelligence does that. You teach the application how to process a specific piece of business, and they do it the same way all the time, right? Highest level of quality. We're always looking to reduce operating expense as well. So if we could reduce the number of interactions that come in and require human intervention, that's perfect in itself. And or reduce the time it takes for an agent who's answering the phone to get the right answer, leveraging the AI as well. And then we measure it with, you know, obviously our financial reduction, our quality assurance metrics, and most of all, the client experience surveys.
And the results so far?
Stellar.
Wow.
And a lot of excitement. So,
what advice do you have? Let's finish with that. What advice do you have for other people, other companies, who are looking at this kind of technology and they're, you know, it's really hard to understand and there's so many buzzwords. Mm-hmm. So what advice do you have for somebody who is not quite as far as you along the pathway?
So I think my recommendation is to start out small with a business case that makes sense. Bring your stakeholders in so that they understand what you're trying to do and don't try to bite off too much at one time. Once you prove out that technology and that it's going to make a lot of sense, you know, within the environment, we're going to end up rolling it out by channel. So take it slow, be aggressive, but don't run too quick.
Tom DeCarlo from UBS, thank you so much.
Thank you. Appreciate it.